Have you ever heard a warning about the weather on the news and then thought, what now? Emergencies don't come with a schedule, but if you know what to do when the moment happens, you're already ahead. Today, we will learn how staying prepared gives you the power to stay safe. Last time, we built an emergency kit with all the basics. What did you put in your kit? Mine had some first aid essentials, water, a phone charger. But here's the thing. Depending on the emergency, you might need to add more. Can you think of any other supplies you might need for different kinds of weather emergencies? Maybe things like extra snacks or a warm blanket. These are smart to have, especially if the weather calls for you to stay put for a while. Being prepared isn't just about the stuff you pack. It's also about knowing what to do when something happens. So today, we're learning how to respond in the moment, whether it's a cold weather emergency, earthquake, tornado, flood, or wildfire. Because once that alert goes off, it's go time. A tornado warning has been issued for your area. Seek shelter immediately.
Wait, a tornado? Right now? Okay. I think we're supposed to go to the hallway? Or the bathroom. Where's the emergency kit? And my flashlight? Oh, I forgot the flashlight again. I meant to add it after last time. And I still didn't practice for where to go for a tornado either.
How do you know when it's time to go or when it's safe to stay? That's where the news and emergency alerts become super important. It gives you updates in real time, like if roads are closed, where fire is spreading, or which areas are flooding. The news helps you understand what's happening and what action to take, so you're not left guessing during a crisis. Do you know how your family gets emergency alerts? Could it be through text or a weather app? Or is it through a news channel like Middle School Me? If you know, jot it down, or ask someone at home how your family stays informed. All right, let's break it down. There are five common types of emergencies in which knowing what to do right away can really keep you safe. Let's look at each one and the smart move to make if it happens. Let's start with one pretty common scenario. We've seen what can happen when the power suddenly goes out. But imagine it's not just dark, it's freezing too. Let's talk about cold weather emergencies, whether it's a snowstorm, freezing rain, or an icy power outage. What would you do in this situation? First, layer up. Put on warm clothes, socks, hats, gloves, even blankets. Staying warm is your top priority. Close doors to rooms you're not using to keep heat where you are. If you have a safe way to heat one room, like a fireplace or battery-powered heater, use it carefully and follow safety rules. And remember, never use a gas stove or oven to heat your home. That's dangerous. Next up, flooding. Imagine heavy rain falling fast, or a river nearby rising higher and higher. Suddenly, streets look more like streams. If water starts to rise, don't wait. Get to higher ground right away. Floods can happen fast. Even a few inches of moving water can knock you off balance, and deeper water can sweep away cars. Never walk or drive through flood water. It might look calm, but it could be hiding strong currents, debris, or even sinkholes. Is flooding something that could happen in your area? different places face different kinds of emergencies. Let's talk about wildfires. These fires can spread super fast, especially when it's hot, dry, and windy. Sometimes you can see or smell the smoke before you even know there's a fire nearby. If officials say it's time to evacuate, don't wait. Fires can change direction quickly, and the smoke alone can be dangerous to breathe. Grab your kit, follow your family's plan, and leave right away. Every minute matters in a wildfire. Next up, earthquakes. If there's an earthquake, don't run around or try to get outside. That's actually when most injuries happen. Instead, drop to the ground and take cover under something sturdy, like a table. That keeps you safer from falling objects. Hold onto something until the shaking stops. Have you ever felt an earthquake before? Now, what if it's a tornado, just like middle school me experienced? You want to get as low as possible and away from windows. The safest place is a small windowless room, like a bathroom, closet, or hallway on the lowest floor, even a basement. The goal is to put as many walls between you and the wind as possible. Cover your head and neck with your arms, a pillow, or even a blanket or mattress if you have time. This helps to protect you from flying debris. Can you spot a similarity between tornadoes and earthquakes? Yes. In both, you want to protect yourself from falling or flying things. Let's see what middle school me did in this situation. Okay, I made it to the hallway this time with my kit and flashlight. Still nervous, but way more prepared. Way to go, me! During any emergency, ask yourself, what does the situation call for? Staying where I am or moving to a safer place? What does the alert or news say I should do right now? Talk to your family and make a plan before anything happens. That way, if the moment comes, you're not guessing. You already know what to do. As we travel back, we learn forward. Every past lesson builds a brighter future. See you next time. Hey, hey.